This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com.
Welcome to How to Spin Yarn, and in this tutorial called Threaded, we are going to be spinning half of an art bat, and we're going to be adding locks into it, Wensleydale locks, and we'll add some more sparkle into it. I've seen this tutorial in several books, and in those books, the authors carry along a thread with their yarn. They also call this technique, I've seen it called barber pole, and a couple other things. And so I've decided for my carry along, I'm going to be using a hand spun worsted weight alpaca yarn just to make this a little bit different. So I'm just going to drop that on the floor, get my leader thread ready to go, tuck in my carry along thread. I'm going to call this yarn my thread. You can use any thread really, as long as it doesn't break super easily. Try metallic, try a contrasting color. The options are limitless. And also you can do something super bulky as your threaded or super fine. I wanted something that would show up easily so that you could see it in the finished yarn. And I'll be spinning on a queen bee today. And this is a 4-ounce bobbin. So already you can see that we're just carrying along this thread and adding a bit of sparkle and texture to this yarn. This is a great way to bulk up your yarn if you want to kind of spread out an art bat and yet get more volume from it. It also almost looks like a 2-ply. It has that barber pull effect. And I'm just having the thread and any embellishments come up in between my pointer and middle fingers while I draft using my thumb and pointer fingers. Beware the tangle. I'm going to take a moment just to untwist this here so that we don't keep having this problem. Okay. So creating that barber pole effect is just one of the different ways we can use this technique. Another way we can use it is we can, let me try creating loops or more of a messy kind of a, we could do little beads actually, like that. So you can use your thread as to create additional embellishments. Make sure whatever embellishments you do fit through your orifice. Let's add some locks. And the way I'm going to do this is just by pinching them with the thread and letting the thread wrap around them and secure them to the yarn. I'm going to up my tension a bit. Sometimes these embellished yarns, I need a lot of uptake to get them onto that bobbin nice and quickly. I almost need the tension to pull the yarn onto the bobbin as I'm spinning. That helps it not get stuck on my hook orifice. Let's add another lock. And this time I'll just fold the lock in half over. That's another way you can add lock. Like that. Almost like wings or a bow. A feather. I like to add feathers facing toward me so that as they go into the orifice, they wrap around as opposed to being put through the orifice and against the grain of the feather. So a simple way to add a feather is just pinch it with your fiber and then wrap your thread around it. This feather had kind of a hard, there we go, we can kind of pull it out. It had a hard, I don't know what that is. Is that a stem? So I would recommend actually kind of cutting that off before adding a feather. But we can always go through after the yarn is out and kind of unloop this feather and pull it out and fluff it up, make it look pretty. Maybe I'll add some more thread beads. Another thread embellishment you can do as you carry this along is wrapping back and forth to make almost a woven section, or almost looks like a braid. And you could do several yards like that. If you have a hook orifice, it's very easy for the hook to catch on little loops that may create. So just sometimes it's nice to take a moment and just wind it on. Maybe we'll do a section of lots and lots of sparkle. I think we need to just freeform spin some locks, kind of like what we did for the uncarded technique where we spun two fibers at the same time. I'm going to do that while I wrap it with this yarn. That's pretty. Almost done. I just spun a little section right here that gave me an idea that I want to try before we're done. I want to try spinning like what we did in thickened, a thick section, and then wrap it with thread and then keep going. So I want this section to be really thick, so I'm just gonna kind of sculpt it together. There we go. Perfect. That's pretty. And now it's rather than holding it, how did I have it in the beginning? Like this, I think. I'm just gonna hold it in my hand and as I draft, bring it down. Sometimes I do notice though that the yarn just covers over it as if I'm core spinning. So at that point, I know it needs more of an angle to wrap on top. If you're struggling with this, you can also try holding it in your other hand and making a 90 degree angle with your finger as you draft, but that can also kind of tire your hand a bit. And that is the end of threaded. I'm going to tie the end in a knot like that. And then I'll show you the bobbin. This bobbin is gorgeous. I think this might be my favorite bobbin so far. Let's see if I can get a good shot of that for you. So pretty. Love. I really like how that came out. I hope you were creatively inspired with maybe some threads or yarns you have in your stash that you can put with some beautiful fibers and turn into gorgeous yarn. Thank you for watching and happy spinning.